to another Kudzukian Thoughts, and I am Larry Robinson. As a music artist, it takes a lot of work, success, and media coverage to be recognized by one name throughout the world. Only a few have ascended to these heights of popularity. Here are some examples: Michael, Mariah, Elton, Reba, Luther, Stevie, Quincy, and here's one, Kanye. Yes, Kanye.
It's amazing, I'm the reason everybody fired up this evening.
In addition to being called a phenomenal music producer and a great artist, he has been called a few other things that aren't necessarily meant to be flattering. How about this one? Classless jerk, because of his actions at the 2009 VMA Awards. Or Gay Fish, which by the writers of the cartoon South Park, they meant this as a total parody on Kanye's tirades. Fergie didn't necessarily mean this as a diss, but she surmises that he and her bandmates make hip-hop gay-friendly. Graceless and Clueless, because of his actions during the Katrina Telethon and the European Music Awards. Everyone has an opinion on Kanye, even the 44th president of the United States. Here's what he had to say.
The young lady seems like a perfectly nice person. She's getting her award. What's he doing up there?
Why would he do that?
He's a jackass.
Is he really a jackass? Or is he a genius? Well, that's for you to decide. Kudzukian Thoughts' goal is to give you both sides of the coin and let you determine if it's heads or tails. Pun intended. One thing remains consistent. He keeps us talking. I believe P.T. Barnum, creator of the greatest show on earth, the Barnum and Bailey Circus, would have absolutely loved Kanye. He once wrote, "I'm indebted to the press of the United States for almost every dollar which I possess. The very great popularity which I have attained both at home and abroad, I ascribe almost entirely to the liberal and persistent youths of public journals of this country." I'm sure Kanye probably echoes some of these sentiments. Let's note some of his most popular media moments, the aftermath, and then let's see if any obvious facts tie them all together.
Wait till I give my money right.
First, Katrina Telethon, September 2005. Kanye decides to go off message to the dismay of Mike Myers, his on-screen partner, and the show's producers, and assert, "George Bush doesn't care about black people." This was witnessed by 22 million viewers. There are at least 30,500 websites that reference this event, and the video has been replayed over 3.5 million times. The results? Kanye West's first media controversy. He's arrived on the scene and the media loves him. He's a new person of interest with an unbridled tongue, and he's ridiculed by many, but that's okay, because he's celebrated by many more. Next, he rushed the stage at MTV's Europe Music Awards because he didn't win the award for Best Video. Over 1.5 million video views on YouTube and other websites. He's now one of Europe's most covered artists, and he tours there extensively, and he has a huge fan base in Europe. Battle with 50 Cent for chart supremacy. This took place in September 2007. This was absolutely a stroke of genius. During a time when record sales were declining, Kanye West and 50 Cent decided that they were going to duel this out in the media. They appeared on award shows, talk shows, they even got magazine covers. Kanye won. The Graduation CD, his most successful studio album to date, sold over 3 million copies, over 1 million in the first week. Kanye seems to welcome attention, but he hates paparazzi. The next media firestorm came in September of 2008. He and his manager decided to physically show the paparazzi how much they disliked him. They wrestled the camera away from a few photographers and actually destroyed them. He later was charged with felony vandalism and was arrested at LAX airport. The incident was covered by every major media outlet in the United States. Now, the event that I believe that he'll be known for the rest of his career, would be the fact that he snatched the mic from Taylor Swift during her acceptance speech for Best Female Artist. This took place in September 2009 in front of 11 million live viewers. It generated over 300,000 tweets within the first hour, approximately 1,650 videos, and 25 million video views on YouTube. This was covered by every major media outlet, television, radio, print, and web. And what is unique about this, these weren't entertainment-related outlets. In many cases, these were your Wall Street Journals, your Fox Business News, CNBC, MSNBC. These were outlets that traditionally were not interested in music or entertainment. But in this case, it really became a major media event. This would probably have cost any brand billions of dollars to gain this much coverage. Another P.T. Barnum quote, but I believe no one lives it more like Kanye. I don't care what they say about me. Just make sure you spell my name right.
Like we always do with this time. I go for mine. I get to shine. Now throw your hands up in the sky. Go for mine. I get to shine. Now throw your hands
up. Now that's one side of the coin. But in the spirit of fair balance, let's look at the entire picture of this media darling. Kanye West was born in Atlanta, Georgia, and was raised on Chicago's culture-rich South Side, the son of two college professors, Ray and the now deceased Dr. Donda West. He arrived on the music scene as an in-house producer for the Rockefeller Music Label. He was first recognized for his production work on Jay-Z's critically acclaimed CD, The Blueprint. Since then, he's made his mark on the music scene with four multi-platinum CDs of his own and an endless list of production credits with everyone from Alicia Keys to Mariah Carey to Michael Jackson. He has 14 Grammy Awards and countless others, and he's easily one of the music industry's most sought-out producers. His impact on today's artists is best summed up by one of today's hottest. Drake had this to say about Kanye in a recent interview. He knows how to utilize great sounds and great music. So before I met him, I had the utmost respect for Kanye. I'd even go as far to say that he's the most influential person as far as musician that I've ever had in my life. I think that's a pretty strong statement. Many of us may hate him, but the media absolutely loves him. Time magazine called him hip-hop's class act. GQ made him their man of the year. Rolling Stone loves him for his passion, and Complex Magazine dubbed him as the most influential brand in the universe. The universe, wow. A formidable businessman, he is the CEO of a very successful music label called Good Music, whose artists include John Legend, Common, and the new kid, Kid Cudi. On the other side, the fashion industry has truly embraced Kanye. He has endorsement and design deals with the likes of Louis Vuitton, Nike, Rolex. He has a new energy drink called Guru, a clothing line that he's just launching called Pastel, and he has a new venture with his dad called the Good Water Store and Cafe. A recent landmark deal with the Fatburger franchise, where he will be opening up 10 franchises in the Midwest. In a deal with Jay-Z's Rockefeller Fragrances, Kanye will be releasing his first fragrance in the summer of 2010. Not bad. If it all ended today, that's a great 8-year run. Kanye West has gone from virtually unknown to world-renowned, very successful, and very wealthy. Now you decide, jackass or genius. One of my friends, Robert Smith, said, "Hey Larry, they're not mutually exclusive. So, for you, I guess you can pick C, all of the above." Now, for my final statement. If it is true that our society honors our living conformists and our dead troublemakers, then we will never truly appreciate the being that is Kanye West until he is gone. Because I believe he's going to cause a stir for the rest of his days on this earth. Until next time, this is Larry Robinson, And this is Kudzukian Thoughts. Bye.
I'm not loving you way I wanted to. What I had to do, had to run from you. I'm in love with you, but the vibe is wrong, and that haunted me all the way home. So you never know, never, never know, never know enough till it's over, love, till we lose control. System overload, screaming no, 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 no. I'm not loving you way I wanted to. See, I wanna move, but can't escape from you. So I keep it low, keep a secret code, so everybody else don't have to know. So keep your love. Something to lose, so I got